Thank you very much. Good afternoon, dear friends and colleagues. On August 20th, 1945, exactly 80 years ago, a special committee was established in our country to organize work in the field of atomic energy. In fact, this date can rightly be considered the birthday of the domestic nuclear industry. Taking this opportunity, I once again congratulate all of you on this anniversary. Everyone who works in Russia's nuclear sector. This is a true force. Almost half a million people. Yes. How many in total? 420,000. Yes, 420,000 specialists. A deep bow to the veterans, to whom we owe our security, our powerful technological advance, and, in fact, our independent, sovereign development. With their talent and titanic will, they created a strong nuclear shield for our country, and were the first in the world to make peaceful atoms work for the benefit of the nation and for all humanity. Scientists, engineers, workers of the nuclear industry accomplished a real feat for the motherland. Those who went into the unknown, risking their lives and health, assembled the first nuclear charges. Those who built testing grounds, power stations, reactors, icebreakers, submarines. The entire country, which had just survived a terrible war with enormous losses and devastation, then undertook colossal work, relying on the scientific, educational, and industrial potential created both in pre-revolutionary Russia and in the Soviet era. Ensuring global nuclear parity became a true victory for all our people. We are proud of the scientific triumphs of outstanding physicists. Igor Kurchatov, Yuli Khariton, Yakov Zeldovich, Nikolai Semenov, Andrei Sakharov, and inspired by the work of those who launched hundreds of new enterprises, research institutes, design bureaus, forming a unique and unified scientific-industrial complex. To preserve and multiply this great legacy, in 2007, we created the state corporation Rosatom. Sergei Vladimirovich played a key role in its creation. Thank you, Sergei Vladimirovich. That decision set a powerful dynamic for the development of the Russian nuclear industry in the 21st century. Today, Rosatom is a global leader in the construction of new power units. Proof of the indisputable reliability and environmental safety of Russian nuclear technologies. Our nuclear scientists were the first to launch into serial operation the safest reactors of Generation 3+. And fundamentally, new solutions are already being created. Fourth-generation energy systems based on fast neutrons and a closed fuel cycle. This will allow us to eliminate radioactive waste and multiply the potential of nuclear energy. Thanks to you and your colleagues, Rosatom today stands at the forefront of advanced technologies, including major infrastructure projects, such as the Northern Sea Route, which is becoming part of the Trans-Arctic Transport Corridor from St. Petersburg through Murmansk to Vladivostok. In Obninsk, Kaluga region, the largest plant in Europe for the production of radiopharmaceuticals is under construction. It will be dedicated to the diagnosis and treatment of complex diseases, including oncological ones. Quantum computers are opening opportunities to develop new medicines, vaccines, materials, and to process colossal amounts of data. Thanks to Rosatom's efforts, Russia has already assembled prototypes of such systems with enormous computing power. They will certainly be in demand for megascience class installations, including those being created at the National Center for Physics and Mathematics in Sarov. This is truly a center of future science, and Rosatom is the driving force behind it. This trajectory of forward movement is absolutely correct. We must set ourselves ambitious goals to make a qualitative leap in the development of our economy and indeed of our entire civilization.
First of all, this concerns work in controlled thermonuclear fusion, an area pioneered by the great Evgeny Pavlovich Belikov.
Thanks to the groundwork that has been laid, developments in this area are already being applied in a wide range of practical solutions.
Russia remains at the forefront of global knowledge and technology here.
These unique advantages must be expanded in close cooperation with Russia's leading scientific centers.
The same fruitful interaction is necessary within another large-scale project.
The creation of a space system based on a special nuclear power unit
and the so-called space tug.
Such solutions open fundamentally new prospects for deep space exploration.
In general, programs of this scale have national and perhaps even global significance.
They are colossal in scope.
They strengthen the country's defense capability and sovereignty,
and, extremely importantly,
they expand opportunities for creativity and self-realization for talented young people,
school children, and students who dream of working in the nuclear industry.
I am absolutely convinced that young specialists, all generations of Rosatom employees,
just like your great predecessors, can handle any, even the most difficult tasks.
This applies both to civilian and defense objectives that depend on the potential of the Russian nuclear industry.
And I repeat, you have already proven this with the outstanding results of your work.
That is why more than 1,400 Rosatom employees have deservedly received state awards for their significant contributions to the development of the industry on this anniversary.
I would like to note that a decree has been signed conferring the title Hero of Labor of the Russian Federation on Viktor Igorovich Ignatov, director of the Kalinin Nuclear Power Plant, and Andrei Alexeevich Karabayev of the Chepetsk Mechanical. And today I will be pleased to present the Order for Valiant Labor to the team of the Russian Federal Nuclear Center, the All-Russian Research Institute of Experimental Physics, within whose walls we are now. Once again, I congratulate all employees and veterans of Rosatom on this anniversary, on this significant historical milestone for all of us and for our entire fatherland. I wish you new successes.